Good morning, all of you. Welcome to your grammar section today. Okay, we are going to do voice, active as well as passive. Voice is divided into two parts, active and passive. Now let us see the structure. Okay, active voice structure is how? Active voice, we have subject, verb and object. And passive voice, we have object plus verb plus by and the subject. I hope you are clear with this. Okay? You know what is active passive voice, 6, 7 standard. You have done it. But just for your, I'm just brushing up. So no, you are not nil. So I'll be also comfortable with you. Now, when to change active voice into passive voice or vice versa, passive into active, okay? What is that? Tense plays a very vital role. Because voices are centered around tenses. So I'll just, with the help of all different tenses what we have done earlier, I'll help you out and show you how to have the changes or how to transform my active voice sentence into passive, vice versa, passive into active. Okay? Now, first I'm taking present tense, right? Present tense we are taking, and I told you that to frame a sentence we need a subject as the structure is there. So these are the subjects I have taken, and you are aware of I, you, we and they, right? And he, she, it, and any name can also be there. Okay, so now I have showed you that subject, you know, either of this one you can use. Now comes the question for the verb. Whenever you have a subject, I, you, we and they, then your verb will be verb minus S or ES. That I told you earlier when I frame sentences and explain you, you will be better understanding. Okay? And when we have a subject, he, she, it or any name, then our verb will be followed with S or ES. This is very important and you should know it. I hope till here it is correct. Now, or you have got it? With the help of examples, I will show you. So, I erase this. Now, present tense, active sentence, I take, where we have, I take the subject, I. Okay? Now, any present tense verb, I take, write. Okay, I write, I write English and writing every day. I write English and writing every day. Or you write I. This is active sentence. Passive, how we make just with the structure? I is subject, write is verb. I told you when I is the subject, we have S, V is minus S. So I write as the original verb, and English and writing, that is the object. Every day is just take it as an accessory. Okay? No grammar book or anywhere you will find this word. For your easy understanding, I have written this. Okay? So, now when we make it passive, see the structure. Object is English and writing. So, English and writing. Okay? English and writing. Now, as you have heard of, that is, to be forms are shown you. Present tense, what we have? Am, is and are. Now, is and am and is with singular subject we have, and are is with plural subject. So, I is singular subject. So, what will be? And English handwriting, which becomes a subject, that is singular. So, English handwriting is. Then verb what we have? Always we will have V3. So is English handwriting is written. WRITTEN. English handwriting is written. Then by has to be there. By whom? By I means me. Got it? So this becomes the subject. That is obvious. Object becomes the subject. Verb is written. Always we will have a to be forms. And then by has to be there. And I becomes me. So this becomes a passive construction. Now let us take another example of this. We let us take. Okay. We submit our journals. Okay. On Mondays. We submit our journals on Mondays. Are you getting me? This is active sentence. We is the subject. This is verb. And our journal is the object. Again, on Mondays. An accessory. Try to keep the accessories wherever it is. Okay. And if you are very sure, I don't mind changing it. So, what is the object? Our journal. Then singular I have written, so is. The submit V3, this is V1, V3 is submitted. Our journal is submitted, okay? By has to be there, V becomes us, okay? And when? On Mondays. So this is a passive construction. Similarly, they we can use, they submit their, instead of our, it will be their journal on Mondays. So their journal is submitted by them on Monday. Okay. Similarly, now let us take a, these are all first person I have taken. Let us take an example of he, she and it or any name. Okay. What we take? He. He drinks 8 glasses of water every day. Okay, he drinks 8 glasses of water every day. So, which is the verb? He is the subject. This is third person. And drinks. I told you he, she, it. Then drink is the verb. S or es is added. So, he drinks 8 glasses of water. This is the object. Again, this is an accessory. I hope you are getting me. Okay. Let us take the, change the thing. So, what is that? 8 glasses. This is active sentence. And we are changing it into passive. So, 8 glasses of water. Okay. Now, 8 glasses of water. Here, glasses is plural. But here, water is singular. It is uncountable. So, 8 glasses, neither singular nor plural. 8 glasses of water is drunk. 8 glasses of water is drunk by him every day. Okay? 8 glasses of water is drunk by him every day. This is the passive construction. So this is in singular. If you take again she, subject, that is, and verb, anything you can take, and the object. It also every day. So in it I will take all the child, and let me take the child learns. Okay, learn plus s. The child learns swimming in SAI, SAI, Sports Authority of India. So the child learns swimming in SAI. What will they say? The child subject or verb and swimming is the object. This is again accessory. So what do we write? Subject is swimming. Swimming, then is learned, 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 or ed, anything you can write is learned by whom? The child. Object, by the child in SAI. Okay, so the child learns swimming in SAI. I've changed the thing into swimming is learned by the child. That is the passive construction. Okay, and it is what? The he, she, it. So I've taken the third person as a subject. Now let us move to the past tense. Past tense, active voice, what we'll say? The mechanic. Okay, the mechanic repaired the leakage. Or just for your easier, repaired the tap. Let us say tap, easy for you to understand. Okay, now the mechanic is subject, repaired past tense, V2 verb, and the tap is the object. So as per the passive, this is active voice. Passive, what become? The tap. And I told you past tense, what it is? Past tense we have was for singular and verb for plural. So here tap was. Okay, then repair is the for V1, part V2 is repaired, and V3 also repaired, ED. Okay, so was repaired, then by has to be there, and who has done it? The mechanic. Okay, the mechanic. So the tap object becomes the subject, was repaired the verb, and by the mechanic. This is a passive sentence, past tense, singular with was. Let us take one more with were. Past tense, plural. Okay, then the books passive, then let us change it to active. The books were distributed. Okay, this is a passive sentence. Both can be interchanged from active to passive and passive to active. The books were distributed by the clerk. Put it here down. By the clerk. The books were distributed by the clerk. The books is subject, were distributed. Books is plural, so were. Verb, and by the clerk, that the clerk is object. Okay, so let us take it. The clerk, okay, were will be, this is added in, was and were in passive, but when we make it active, this will be removed and we take distributed. So what did the clerk do? The clerk distributed what? The books. The clerk distributed the books. Okay? So this is becoming what? The subject. This is verb. And this is the object. This object here is the subject. And verb is were plural, were distributed by the clerk. So this is active voice changing into passive, but I had done the other way. Passive has changed into active. Both are possible. Now, let me take future tense. getting me. Future tense sentence, let us take future tense, you know. Future tense is what? Structure will also slightly change. So I'll just show you afterward. Future tense we have will and shall. Okay? Will and shall. So what do we do? This will be, we will be added to both. Will be and shall be in the passive voice. Future tense we are taking. And how will be the structure? Same subject plus verb, that is will, plus or shall, whatever. Okay? You know where to use will and shall goes with whom? With I and we. So will, shall plus verb plus the object. Okay? So in passive, how will it be? Passive will be the passive voice, it will change, and how it will be? It is as it is. Object, okay, plus will ya shall plus be plus verb plus the object. OVS is same. By will be written here. By O. Okay. So how, let us take one example. So this subject, verb and object. I will check, C-H-E-C-K, check your notebooks. I will check your notebooks. Okay? Today. Might be the teacher says, I'll check your notebooks today. I, subject, will check. This is the verb, will, because it's future tense, and your notebooks is what? It's the object, today again, and accessory. So how do we do? Object, your notebooks, this is active sentence, future tense. We are making it passive. So your notebooks. Okay, now I told you will be, because will is there, will be, your notebooks will be checked, C-H-E-C-K-E-D, be, three, check, checked, check, will be checked by, okay, I, so me today. This is the passive construction. For example, instead of will, I put here shall, because shall also goes. Then how would be? I shall check your notebooks today. So passive will not be if you change, because I told you will be and shall be. But here your notebooks. Here even though it is shall, here notebooks are not the I or we only goes with shall. So notebooks are what? Notebooks are the things, object. So will be only will be there, even though shall is here. So notebook shall be checked, no, notebooks will be checked. So please keep in mind, only with I and we the shall goes, and that will be there. Otherwise will be goes with all I, you, we, they, he, she, it. Okay, so this is plural, will be goes. So this is the passive construction in future tense. Few more examples with he, let me take. He will, or let us take my father. My father will attend what? The marriage. My father will attend the marriage on Sunday. Okay? Or you can name a place in Mumbai. Anything. Anyone, huh? Okay? On Sunday in Mumbai also will do. My father will attend the marriage on Sunday in Mumbai. This is also a construction, the correct construction of active voice. So my father is subject, will attend, this is the verb, future tense, not yet attended. and what the marriage, this is the object. Okay, and on Sunday in Mumbai is can be taken as an accessory. This remains as it is. So how do we change it into, this is active sentence. Let us make it passive. What will be the marriage? Okay. And will is there. So will be and attended. Will be attended. Okay. By whom? By my father. By my father. Well, okay. On Sunday, as it is in Mumbai. This is a passive construction of future tense. I hope you have got it. Let us take some negative sentences. How we do it? Of all the three, we have done present tense, past tense, and future tense, active sentence, and passive. Okay, structure you know, so I just erase it right now. And not for negative sentence. I. You take I? Okay. Ram, I'll say. Ram will not show the answer. This is a future tense. Future tense, negative answer, sentence. Ram will not show the answer. Same pronoun, subject, will not show because negative is there. This whole is the verb and the answer is the object. So, as this is active voice, okay, this is passive. So, what will we do? The answer and will not remains the answer will not remains not as it is. Show, showed, V3 is again showed. So will not be has to be there. I told you will not be showed. Okay. By whom? By Ram. This is the passive construction of negative sentence. Remains the same. Only will not. Okay, not is added, will be, I told you, will has to be there or shall be in passive, so it is there. So, showed by Ram, this is passive sentence. Let me take one more of, I hope you are getting me children, any doubts you can just clear up. Okay, let me take a present tense sentence, sorry, okay. He, then, doesn't. He doesn't speak English properly. He doesn't speak English properly. Then he subject. Okay, as per our construction active. He doesn't speak English. Doesn't speak English. Doesn't speak is the verb. And English is the object properly. It shows how. So, let us take it as an accessory. We have to change only subject, verb, object, SVO. So, passive sentence, what happens is, English is the object. So, let us put it here. Okay. English is singular, is, doesn't, not, doesn't is because he is there. So, he, she, it, does. I, you, we, they, do or don't. And he, she, it, does or doesn't. English is not speak, spoke, spoken. V3. Not spoken. Okay. Whom? By him. Properly. English is not spoken by him properly. This is active sentence, passive. Let us take a past tense sentence. He or she, you are not comfortable with he, always madam is taking he. Okay, she broke, didn't, past tense, so do past tense, did. She didn't lend him money. Clear? Or if you want to take some other sentence? Okay, no problem. She didn't show or stop. I don't know. She didn't scold. Let us take teacher. You are very fond of scolds. She didn't scold the child. She didn't scold the child. Scold is past tense. Okay? So she is the subject, active voice, past tense. Didn't scold is the verb, did not. Did is verb, past tense. The child is object. So the passive construction will be how? The child. Okay, past tense. So was not, singular. Child was not scold, scolded. The child was not scolded, but has to be there. And she saw her. This is past tense negative sentence. Okay? So we have done present tense, past tense, and future tense, singular, plural, okay? Positive, that is affirmative or negative sentences. I hope you are clear and comfortable. Next lecture, I continue with the perfect tense. Thank you for watching the video. Okay, please subscribe and press the bell icon for further videos for you to watch. Thank you for watching it.